Dare to play. I'm Nancy Drew. This is my center of operations, my desk. Go ahead and poke around. If you want to know the particulars of how I do what I do, take a look at the book titled How to Be a Detective. It's really helpful, especially if you're new to the mystery solving business. And be sure to check out my scrapbook. I put memorabilia from all my past cases in there. A lot of them were pretty dangerous and at times really scary. But don't say anything about that to my dad, okay? He worries about me enough as it is. And whatever you do, read what's in the file called Case File. That'll tell you all about the mystery I'm about to try to solve. If you think you're ready to dive into that mystery, just click on the plane ticket and you'll be on your way.
Hi there, I am not Nancy Drew. I am Ralphie993, and this is my first Let's Play, Nancy Drew's 23rd edition Shadow at the Water's Edge. Because I got the case file, but I kind of think it's a waste of time, and I really kind of want to just get right into the game. Just a few little things before we go over everything. Here's our inventory bag. Our journal. We put, like, notes about, like, observations, phone numbers, clues in there. Checklist, which we won't actually be using because we're going to play Senior Detective, Cell Phone, Settings, Load Game, Save Game, Power. So this is my first Let's Play. And I thought I'd go with a computer game because it's the most convenient for me to record, and I'm relatively good at these ones. Anyway, Senior Detective. So here we are. Going into the inn. Inn, I guess. Nice little lobby. With slippers! Slippers. They're all the same size. I bet you Nancy did not take off her slippers. She didn't even stop. She's just walking right in. Nice photo. Hi!
Hi, I have a reservation under Nancy Drew.
Oh dear. It responded to our name.
Do you believe me now?
Obasan, it only fell.
No, it didn't.
It did not.
Shattered.
You know better.
Her expression.
Very sorry. She's just a little upset.
Well, the picture broke. She'll be upset.
She does not want her here. Tell her to go.
Oh, wait. Someone doesn't want me here. Oh, crap.
What was that about? Why is she upset?
Please, don't worry about that. Here. This is your room key.
Oh, why, thank you. At least someone wants me to stay here.
Thanks.
I'm 24.
Your room is on the second floor.
Remember that.
I've already had your bag sent up. Please, my name's Miwako. Come to me if there's anything you need.
Score, thank you. Grandma's been replaced by a robotic cat.
Is that a robotic cat?
Yeah, Suki.
Yeah, the old lady was her
Isn't
grandma.
Isn't she the greatest? Lentalo got Suki. Her for me. I've wanted my own pet cat for forever, but I can't have one at the ryokan. I came into work one day, and there she was, right next to the sweetest note from Lentaro.
I've never seen a robotic cat before. What does it do?
She's not an it. She's Suki.
Yeah, Nancy, don't call it
an
it.
She didn't mean it. Actually, she doesn't really do much. Mainly sits. But, oh, wait. I just learned something neat.
Okay.
Suki, tatte.
Oh, it's... kind of creepy, but kind of cute at the same time.
Oh, that's great.
That's all I remember right now, but she can do a lot more. I should figure out what the rest of the commands are, come to think of it.
Mm-hmm.
Although, to be honest, it's a little more believable if she just does what she wants.
Yeah, that is believable. It's a cat. Cats don't respond to commands.
Your grandmother seemed very upset about the portrait breaking.
It's no big deal. She thinks it's a bad sign that the portrait fell from the wall.
Why is that?
It's a very special portrait. It's one of the two remaining images of my mother, and it was taken shortly before... It's one of my grandmother's favorite portraits.
Nice save. Happened to your mom?
What happened to your mother?
Is she dead?
I shouldn't bother you with our problems, Nancy.
She's probably
dead. It is very nice outside. A perfect time to relax and enjoy your surroundings.
No. Well, you really cut us off, didn't you? That's poor service.
Nancy, please be careful. There's too much broken glass.
But it tried to jump at me. Anywho, yes. So we're just entering the game. You kind of get thrown into a lot of the action. Not techniques, but basic controls of the game include when the magnifying glass goes red, there's a point of interest, like this fish over a fire. And now our magnifying glass is a hand.
Don't touch that.
Whoa. Then don't have it out there. This game, you want to touch everything.
Everything.
All right, here's a book. Ghost Stories of Japan. There's a few things, books in here. Okiku and the Nine Plates. This is a story about how a young girl was tricked into believing that she broke the samurai's, like, 10 magical plates. And she went out to find them, but she fell down a well. So sad, before she could find the 10th one. So she comes out of a well at night and, I don't know, it's a spirit. So the book says calls out, you know it's a spirit. It's probably going to be screaming or something like that. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. And then she's pulled back into the well. Kind of tragic. But some say the ghost was finally released from the well if a neighbor calls out 10 as she said it. So that could be an interesting story. This poor girl falling into a well. Anywho, okay, that's the entrance where we came from. There's the slippers. Slippers. Here's another interesting book here. Famous Kyoto Gardens, A Visitor's Guide. So this is playing rock gardens of Temple of the Peaceful Dragon. Because that's the Japanese name. But you know what? I'm not going to even try to say it. I'll probably say it very wrong. So we're going to say Temple of the Peaceful Dragon. That's what that means. But yeah, it's just describing different stones. The 5 basic stone types used in a rock garden. We got soul stone, the body stone, heart stone, branching stone, and ox stone. Interesting little bit of info there. Let's back away from here. Back away, I say. Back away. Okay. Let's see here. Now, I think we should probably go to our room next. So, which way is our room? I think our room's this way. It's on the upper floor, but there's 2 ways you can get to the upper floor. Oh, phone. Crap. Answer the phone, Nancy!
Hello?
Nancy! You made it! How was your ride?
It was pretty good.
I love Japan. I have done so much shopping, and George's convention is crazy. I've never seen so many people. It's totally sold out.
You sound pretty excited.
Kind of hard not to be here. I don't even know where to start. Have you ever had mochi?
Mochi?
It's a revelation.
It's a revelation.
I'm not even kidding. And the shopping.
I've never tried mochi.
You covered me in already.
Oh, yeah. Does that do it? No? Okay.
No?
No, hit the... No, the...
You do it, then.
We all on?
Yes.
Yeah.
Yep. Why is that so hard?
It so isn't.
It's hard because you're incompetent, Bess.
What's your story? What are you up to? You coming over?
I'm still getting settled in, but I'll be out to see you guys soon.
How's the... whatever it is you're staying at?
Ryokan. It's great. A little strange, though. When I was checking in, a picture fell off the wall, and everyone was really weird about it.
Huh. Oh, no. Our train's going to be here in a sec. Gotta go.
See you, Nancy.
Bye.
Yeah, we'll be getting interrupting phone calls a few times in this game, which really sucks, because I hate talking to the characters on the phone. I really do. So, if you want to, like, complete walkthrough of this, like, including all the conversations with, like, Bess and George and those you can contact via telephone, it's not going to happen with me. Sorry. Now let's use the key to get into the room. There we go. Here's our room. We got a little table. And what's this? A nice little balcony, which we can't actually go out of, but okay, whatever. Pretty little door, though. We don't actually have, like, an actual bed. Oh, here's our suitcase. What kind of clothes is Nancy wearing today? Hackmeister. I don't know what that is. It doesn't look familiar. Oh, what's this? Vesca. It's important. Yeah, and when you click on something and then the hand shows up with like the little toolbox, it means it goes into your inventory. So then we can come to the inventory box here and see there's the book and there's the fast card we just picked up. And the, train pass. It's train pass. There you go. Nothing else in there though. Yeah, so we'll just basically just exploration. I do like to explore. What do we got here? Here's a pamphlet for the Riacon, the place we're staying at.
If I have something to send, this might come in handy.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, that is what envelopes are used for, Nancy. Sending mail. Alright, that's just a little pamphlet talking to us about the Riacon we're staying at. The hot bath in room number across from room 7. Nothing too interesting there. Front desk open from 7 a.m. to 1 a.m. There's some stuff going on in town. Well, we've got the train pass. You should probably go. We would be able to go out and investigate those things. Which we'll do. Maybe not in this episode. Oh, right, yeah. The reason why Nancy's in Japan is because we're doing some sort of, like, teacher exchange thing. So there are these, like, files in here.
Let's see how they did.
Where you can, like, mark kids' work based on their English skills, because we're teaching them English, right? I don't think you have to be honest. I'm not going to do that here. It's not crucial to the storyline at all. But there's what's your name, student bios, and, you know, I just... Oh, these are just the bios, but different kids. 7, 7, 7, 7, 7. A bunch of seventh graders. A bunch of second graders with a 2 there. I don't know. That's as long as Japanese kids have the same school system as North America, where you're 7, you go on to grade 2. I'm pretty sure they have the same. Alright, let's explore this place. Let's check it out. I wonder if this must be the hot bath. Let's see, is it across from room 7? It's across from room 7. Oh, whoa, dear.
Hang on. Man only right now.
Oh, okay.
What do you mean?
What if Nancy is a man?
The baths. The blue banner means the baths are for men. The red banner means women only.
Okay, fair enough.
I don't know why we don't mention this at the front desk. This is useful information.
That is useful.
I'm Rentaro.
Hi, Rentaro.
I'm out in the garden if you need anything.
So he's graceful. So he's the guy who made the robotic cat for Miwaku. That's kind of cool. Yeah, so you can't go in there. Men only. We'll have to wait till it's a red banner for the women. I think that's gonna be all for this episode so far. Got a little bit of exploration done. Well, maybe we can do a little bit more. I got a little bit more time. Let's see here. Cultural room, lesson 7 to 10:30. I have no idea what time it is, but we can go in here.
Nancy-san, please sit.
Will do, sit.
It is a pleasure to meet you, Parapali. I am sorry for the way I behaved when you first arrived. It was very impolite.
Yeah, it kind of was.
Please forgive me.
Of course, don't worry. It's nice to meet you as well.
Nancy's so forgiving.
That is very kind of you to say, but I must always worry about the guests who stay with us, especially now.
Oh.
What do you mean, especially now?
Are you here for a lesson
you
today?
You didn't answer my question. Yes, we are. But you know what? We're going to do the lesson. Yeah, you nod your head. We're going to do the lesson next episode. We'll cut off. It's coming close to my episode ending. They're going to be kind of short, but oh well. These games aren't terribly long, so you don't have to worry about long parts of it. So yeah. So next episode, we'll get a lesson from Take, I believe her name is. Yeah, Take. All right. See you guys then.